Well, welcome to hopefully the first of many vlogs. I'm gonna try to start doing this because my thinking is the more content I have on my channel, the more of either I can continue to watch myself because I'm the only one watching my videos, or maybe when I die in a heroic fire, people will come to my YouTube channel and they'll say, oh, look, she did a vlog. She did a lot of vlogs. Because I'm not going to promise every day. I mean, even now, I tried to time myself and it took 10 minutes to set up everything. But, you know, time is of an essence when you have a lot of nothing to do every day. So I'm going to have to think wisely about my time. But I'll tell you this, what you'll get from these blogs. You're not going to get a lot of the same things that you get on YouTube that, you know, what's up guys? This is me, your girl Pure Sugar, and I'm coming at you. We're going to start this blog. Ready? Let's go. So anyway, I want to talk about today why I plan on murdering my cat, Roscoe. He is very annoying sometimes. And before people get offended, you know, especially my girlfriend, I'm sure if you had a cat that you loved, you would at one point in time say, this cat's so annoying. I want to murder it. Don't act like you've never had shaken baby urges with your cat. Don't judge me. But, you know, you also got to think about, what if a cat was a person? Because I love my cat like a person. And as a person, my cat is so fucking annoying. Like, if I had a person, when I go to the bathroom and I close the door, completely bang on the door the entire time I'm trying to use the bathroom, I would murder that person. That's just how my instinct is. You're knocking on the door when I'm in the bathroom, you're gonna get murdered. But also, if I don't close the doors when I'm using the bathroom, also don't judge me because you don't have to always close the door when you use the bathroom in your own apartment. If I don't close the doors, then he just walks right in. I was like looking at me in my face while I'm using the bathroom. Like, I don't understand how that's appropriate in cat culture, because it's not appropriate in people culture. It's not. But that's not the only reason. I can talk forever about this. You know, he has a routine. Every morning, he's supposed to eat at 7:30 a.m. But, you know, as a human or as a cat who can't tell time, for some reason, he thinks it's appropriate to wake everyone up at 6 a.m. He's like, oh, well, it must be 7 o'clock in time for me to eat because I'm hungry now. So, you know, instead of being polite and being like, hey, I'm awake, I'm hungry, help me, he proceeds to stick his hand right into my face, just claws and all. Like, it would be one thing if he was like, hey, you know, I'm hungry, help me, I'm starving, which he is not, but he decides to be like, hey, help me. Not cool as a person or as a cat. Very annoying. Also, at inappropriate times, he decides to get into my personal space, and it's clear whether you're a cat or a person, I'm busy. Like, you know, I feel like cats and dogs, they can sense a lot of things, But one of those things is not when you're busy. Or the other explanation is they don't give a fuck. Because if I have something in my lap, whether it be food or like my computer or papers, apparently it's fair game to like jump up there and try to get my attention. When the whole entire day I could be doing nothing and this motherfucker is dead asleep. But the second I start doing something, it's time. It's time to like sit in my lap. And it's not like there's not like 600 something square feet for him to occupy. That time is time to be in my lap. Whatever. You know, I have some good things to say about him, despite all the bad things. He's very handsome, very cute. He's got a little diamond face. And he's funny. He's hilarious. He talks. He knows English, and also he knows cat. So he knows two languages, so he's super smart. He's just a unique, cool cat. But he's also an annoying asshole. So like all family members, he's that family member who's like an annoying douchebag. But he's also super cool to be around and hang out with. So that's it about my cat. Now, before I end this vlog, I think every vlog I'll talk about a song I like. Won't necessarily be my favorite song, but I mean, probably will. This goes on the list as one of my favorite songs. It's been my favorite song for a long time. So that means it's my favorite song. Like, you know, sometimes I'm like, oh, I love this song. I'm gonna listen to it and I'm gonna put it on a playlist and I'm gonna never get tired of it. And then months and months and months go by of me listening to it and I'm like, this song is good, but I can't listen to it anymore. That's not the case with this song. The name of this song is, I love how it's my favorite song and I don't know the name of it. The name of the song is Back to My Love by Becky Hill. Back to my love. Now, I don't know a lot about Becky Hill. I'm not gonna say I'm a huge expert on her, but she's got another song that's also on my favorite songs playlist. You have to hear this song. Like, it's not so much about the words, because sometimes songs to me aren't like about the words. Like, you know, listen to Cardi B songs. They're good songs, but are they about the words? This song has some good words, but, or good lyrics, whatever you want to say, but it's not about that. Becky Hill's voice is so good. It's super soulful. It's like, it's just got like a good non-poppy tone to it. Not saying anything's wrong with poppy tones, because if I continue to do these vlogs, you're gonna know that I like some poppy songs. So it's not about that. It's just good to have something different, and the beat is amazing. The whole tone of the song is so good. So if you haven't heard it yet, listen. It's got a, on a scale of like one being like a slow Adele ballad, a slow Adele song being a one, and like a 10 being like a dubstep Little John song. It's on the scale of like, I want to say a 70 for vibe, because it's got a chill vibe to it, but it's not going to put you to sleep. When you hear it, you're going to be like, oh man, yeah, this is a good song. Is it for everyone? No, I'm not going to pretend like it's for everyone, but it's a good song. You should listen to it. I'm gonna try to put it in the background, you know, I don't know the YouTube, like, you can't play that song vibe. It's a low-key song. I haven't heard it on the radio yet, so maybe I can get away with playing it. But listen to that song. Hopefully in the future, if I do more of these, I'll put it on a playlist. But burping is acceptable in vlogs. Anybody who's seen some of my other videos knows I burp. That's human nature. I'm not gonna fart, so this is the appropriate end. Anyway, if you stayed this long, thanks a lot. Check out my other videos. Subscribe, click the bell icon, like it. Comment below one of your favorite songs or some of your crazy cat stories. And if your cat is annoying. And also, have a great day and a great life. Thanks a lot. Back to my